Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm Rulla Alani and today I have a very exciting video because I will be sharing the top most quality online dating apps. So if you're familiar with my channel, then you know that I steer far away from Tinder because I prefer elite dating apps. So you're not gonna find Tinder on this list, but I will be sharing seven quality dating apps that I recommend for all of you in 2021. So at number one, we have a dating app that houses 5 million users worldwide, and it was actually voted the top dating app for millennials by Mashable. And this dating app is Hinge. So Hinge has gained quite a lot of popularity in the last several years. I have a lot of friends who swear by it, and it's an app that I personally have not used, but I think it's a great starter app to get you in the right direction, right? Now, would I say Hinge is the number one spot to meet high quality, elite individuals? No, but do I think that it's way better than apps such as Tinder, Bumble, Coffee Meets Bagel? Yes, so that's why I've included it on this list. And as you guys are gonna see with this list, I left my favorites for last, the ones that I mention all the time, and I'm trying to introduce you guys to some more apps that I have not mentioned ever before on my channel. So let's talk more about Hinge. Okay, so according to Mashable, Hinge is described as a thoughtful combo of Tinder's quick swiping and Match's relationship base. So as you can see, they're kind of combining the best of both worlds because you have the ease of the navigation of swiping, but then you have users who are actually looking for relationships and marriage. When it comes to the users, on average, they're between the ages of 24 to 32, and there's also basically a 50-50 split of both men and women. Now, the nice thing about Hinge is you're not gonna find many fake profiles because they actually require 6 photos in order for you to sign up, and you actually need to include a Facebook account or a phone number in order to have your account go through the verification process. So I really appreciate that Hinge is kind of adding these extra steps in order to ensure that their users are protected and there's no fake or spam profiles on there. Now, the motto for this app is the dating app designed to be deleted. I love that. As you guys know, I'm someone who really, really looks for a dating app that has the end goal in mind. My biggest pet peeve with Tinder is it's very addictive, and the whole kind of premise of Tinder is to keep people swiping on the app. Their goal isn't for you to find love. It's actually for you to stay on the app. However, with apps such as Hinge, they are actually kind of wanting people to find love and eventually delete the app. So I really, really like that motto. So while other apps promote a hookup culture, I think Hinge is doing a great job kind of announcing that they are having a more serious nature on their app. And it is confirmed knowing that actually Match bought them out in 2019. So knowing that Match.com is behind Hinge gives it even more credibility and gives you more trust in knowing that the people signing up are going to be more serious and more mature. The other nice thing is Hinge might be a great place for introverts. They actually provide some icebreakers and different conversation topics, so this can really help get the ball rolling. I know dating can be overwhelming, and it's really nice to have those added features that make it a little bit less nerve-wracking. Last but not least, according to an article by Elle magazine, it's reported that Hinge is the Instagram of dating apps. In their latest survey, Hinge found that they are setting up a date every 4 seconds. Wow, that's some good statistics. And it's not just based on pictures either. Profiles are made up of questions and quotes. You can learn a lot about someone from their answers, whether it's their favorite friends line or their pet peeve. So I really like that Hinge kind of offers these quirky things on your profile. It's not just the average about me, about my match. They really go above and beyond for you to get to know these matches before you go on a date. So I really think that Hinge is a great option, especially for millennials, especially those who have maybe tried apps such as Tinder in the past and they want to try something a little bit more elevated. At number two, we have a relatively new concept that launched in 2015. Now, this is a platform that's not only for dating, but it's also for networking and actually looking for career opportunities. This app is known as Raya. Also, I'm not sure if it's pronounced Raya or Raya, but we're just gonna go with Raya. So, how does it work? According to the App Store, prospective members may download the app and submit an application. Once submitted, applications are placed in queue and reviewed continually. An applicant's status can change from waitlisted to accepted at any time. Once accepted, members have the option to purchase a 1, 6, or 12-month auto-renewing membership and will have full functionality of the entire service while their subscription is active. So, Raya is really, really big on privacy. They're really big on trust. And one of the reasons for this is, wow, they house some of the most exclusive people. Now, you ladies are gonna go nuts, but I heard that Channing Tatum has reportedly been seen on this app. So if that doesn't make you want to sign up, I don't know what will. I honestly am considering even signing up for this app in terms of their networking opportunities. I think it's a wonderful way to get in the scene, to get in the know, to get your name out there and to start talking to people. It's 2021. A lot of us are now connecting online. So I really think that Raya came up with this idea at the perfect time, especially during COVID now. A lot of us still want to network, whether it's date, we want to find career opportunities, we want to find new meaningful friendships, and I think Raya is really making that convenient. So let's talk about some of the guidelines, because this app is very, very strict and they will boot you very quick from what I've been reading. So this app is really strict and it's almost impossible to create a fake profile. Keep in mind that only 8% of applicants are accepted. So this is a pretty, pretty esteemed cutthroat community. Let's just say that. I know some of the top universities in the whole United States have higher acceptance rates than that. So let's just start there. Raya is very, very exclusive, and it's clear from their numbers. So your application must be approved by an anonymous committee of 500 individuals who decide if you're successful, attractive, and well-known enough to join. So I know it sounds a little bit daunting, but hey, what do we have to lose by just submitting an application? Even if we're waitlisted, you have a huge opportunity to connect with some really, really amazing individuals. Now let's talk about the users. So you must be 18 or older to join, and there are currently 10,000 users. But get this, you guys, there are 100,000 people currently on the waitlist. The nice thing is the price tag is actually not that bad. So once someone is vetted in, Raya is paid, and it's $7.99 for 1 month or $29.99 for 6 months. So this is actually a very, very reasonable charge to pay. Now, you're gonna see on this list, I've included some apps that are quite expensive. There are some that are $20 a month, $40 a month, and there's some that's $100 a month, and even more than that. So the fact that Raya is only $7.99 a month, I mean, that's almost like a Netflix subscription. That really is not a high price to pay. So it shows you that, yes, Raya is very exclusive and cutthroat to get in, but once you're in, the charge is not very high, so I think it's worth it. And honestly, just reading this list, I would say Raya is one of the top apps that I recommend, and it's also an app that I personally myself have never used. So I do want to say that I have not used Hinge, I've not used Raya. I've actually only used the last two apps on this list. So you'll have to wait till the end to see which ones those are. But if you've been watching my videos now, you probably know what those apps are because I talk about them quite frequently. Okay. Let's talk about some fun facts when it comes to Raya. Vogue writer Carly Schiartioni, I'm probably butchering that, I'm sorry Carly, she calls Raya the Soho House of dating apps. Now, if you're not familiar with the Soho House is also a members-only based community. So the Soho House features different venues all over the world. I know they have some in Los Angeles. I think they have them in London, Tokyo, Dubai, if I'm not mistaken. It's some of the most extravagant cities in the world. And what it is it's basically a community. You pay an annual membership and then you're allowed entrance to certain venues across the country. What makes it so special? Well, once again, they only accept certain members into this group. The Soho House group only consists of creative individuals. They can be music artists, they can be poets, they can be, you know, in the movie industry. It doesn't matter. They just need to be, once again, different from your average Joe. They need to have some amazing qualities about them that's going to help them elevate the community, right? So Raya is basically a digital version of the Soho House. The founder of Raya, Daniel Gendelman, told Kevin Ruse of the New York Times that you don't need to be an attractive Instagram star and that flaunting wealth is actually a red flag. Quite interesting. Raya aims to curate digital dinner parties full of interesting and passionate people, he said, adding that he envisions it as a meeting place for influential people to create projects. Not too surprised here, but apparently you'll get a warning for screenshotting a convo or profile. So that's really insane. So if you're on this app and you happen to see someone famous or you happen to receive a message from someone famous and you screenshot it, Raya will be notified right away. So they really, really value privacy. And as I've said before, Channing Tatum has been reportedly looking for love on this app, along with Cara Delevingne, Drew Barrymore, Amy Schumer, Ben Affleck, John Mayer, Kelly Osbourne, Joe Jonas, Trevor Noah. All of these celebrities have been reported on the app. All right, so that basically wraps up all about Raya. As you guys can see, it's a pretty amazing app. I mean, the more research I've done on it, it just makes me want to apply. It seems exclusive, right? And at the end of the day, I think we all want to be a part of the fun, and it seems like Raya's really doing it big. So I highly recommend Raya at the number 2 spot. At number 3, we have Elite Singles. Elite Singles is one of the best dating apps for people looking for love, especially among the older age group. So the average user on Elite Single is from age 30 to age 50. So they're definitely going to be people with a lot more wisdom on this app. Also, the added benefit of Elite Singles is that you don't need any social media platform in order to join. I've noticed that a lot of dating apps are now requiring you to, you know, have a Facebook account, a LinkedIn account, an Instagram account in order for you to join. But the nice thing about Elite Singles is you don't need any other social media platform in order to join. You just need an email address. Also, nice bonus about Elite Singles is they send you 3 to 7 curated matches daily. Also, I really want to mention this because I know I tend to talk a lot about traditional heterosexual dating, but I really like to mention that Elite Singles offers lesbian, gay dating, child-free dating, Christian dating, you name it. They offer all of it. So I really, really recommend Elite Singles for people who are older, people who are looking for more specific types of dating. It really seems like a great app that really unites everyone and embraces diversity. In terms of their paid membership, there's a 3-month option, which is $57.95 per month. It's not cheap. Their 6-month option is $44.95 per month, and their 12-month option is $31.95 per month. So now you guys can see why I was speaking so highly about Raya's price being almost $8 a month. Most of these high quality dating apps are going to be closer to the $30, $50 range per month. So Raya's price tag is very affordable in comparison. All right, and number 4, we have The League. So The League is another elite dating app that requires you to provide information about yourself in order to be approved and gain access. The information isn't anything too precise, isn't anything too precious, and it's not anything that you wouldn't want out in the public. It does include your LinkedIn account, your job title, and your educational background. So if you're not comfortable with providing any of those, then you'd probably want to skip out on this app. This is a quote And it says, the league brings together users of all ages, nationalities, sexual preferences, and educational backgrounds. The common thread is the ambition and a drive to succeed. So I really, really like that league is targeting motivated individuals, right? They don't care about your age, your background, your sexual orientation. Once again, this is another app that caters to gays and lesbians and all sorts of dating, so that's also something that I'd like to mention. The other nice thing is the league is really, really providing some more innovative features. So let's talk about those. They currently have a league live option, and this is held every Sunday. So every Sunday at 9 p.m., you can go on 3 dates in 9 minutes. So think of like a little speed dating session, but literally from the comfort of your couch. So this is kind of how they're dealing with the pandemic. And I really like that they're spicing things up and allowing more features, especially with this high price tag. I like that they're offering, you know, a little bit more of a unique user experience. They also have video chat options for their paid members. So let's talk about the paid accounts. They're not cheap, okay? If you're gonna go in for just 1 month, it's $100.99, pretty steep. If you're going to go for 3 months, it's $299, and if you're gonna go for 6 months, it's $300.99. So that is our option number 4, the league. Number 5, we have a dating app, and this is Inner Circle. So let's talk a little bit about Inner Circle. So they have a screening process in order to ensure membership stays within the Inner Circle guidelines. They also hold real life single events. This dating app is marketing more like an exclusive club than something you play with while you're waiting for the bus. So this is definitely an elite app. And it is also like LinkedIn. So you do get notified when someone looks at your profile. I don't know how I feel about that. I kind of don't like the apps that show users when you view their profile, because I personally feel like you should be able to view a profile without that being public info. I mean, I know personally when I was online dating and I would see someone that I was interested in, I would be wanting to go show their profile to all of my friends. So I would be mortified if they saw that I was viewing their profile like 7 times in a day, right? But I just want to mention that, okay? So they will see when you view their profile. Okay, so let's not view their profile too often. You'll also get alerts when someone's checking out your profile though, so that's kind of nice. This is what was reported on the Inner Circle website. So it says, we believe that online dating should be exciting, it should be empowering, it should be real. That's why Inner Circle has created a vibrant global community of like-minded individuals. We strive to deliver a quality experience for each member, ensuring you meet the people you want to meet. You should not have to swipe endlessly, thank God, because I hate that. That's why our community has an application process for new members to join, resulting in a diverse community full of inspiring and ambitious singles who are on the same page in life. But that's not all we do. We take the online offline. Hosted in some of the most sought-after venues around the world, we put on exclusive monthly events, meaning matches can become experiences and your real-life love story can begin. So wow, Inner Circle seems very, very nice. I really like that they're integrating both the online and the real physical in-person experience, especially with COVID. I mean, anytime I see a dating app really making strides to make the user experience more convenient, more just more innovative, right? We always want to applaud dating apps that are going the extra mile. So I really, really like that they're setting up these monthly in-person events where you can actually meet matches in a safe manner. So Inner Circle, once again, has both free and paid membership. So if you're going to go with paid, 1 month is $39.99. If you're going to sign up for 3 months, then each month will be $26.66. And if you're going to sign up for 6 months, then each month is $19.99. Okay, Finally, the number six spot, we have one of my personal favorites because it's one that I've used and one where I've personally found love, and that is Luxy. So Luxy was founded in 2014, and on their website, they state that they are the best elite and millionaire dating site in the world, okay? So Luxy pairs outstanding and sophisticated singles. Luxy's exclusive community is highly esteemed by its members. We make sure only sophisticated, successful people of quality join our platform. They also have a vouching process, which is quite picky. I have had gorgeous, successful friends who were rejected, so don't take it personal and just try again. I've had several friends who have tried 2-3 times and they were eventually vouched in. So just keep optimizing your profile, keep kind of doing the self-work, growing, you know, working on yourself, right? Because when we work on ourselves and when we prioritize ourselves and our growth, then we're more attractive to more people, right? That's just how life works. The more we invest in ourselves, the more we're attractive to outside people in the world. So don't take it personal for any of these apps if you're not vouched in, right? Just try again. And that's the nice thing with Luxy is you can try as many times as possible. Also, I want to say, like, feel free to message me on Instagram. I would love to help you ladies out, whether you're creating a profile. I've had several people message me to ask me kind of what to write on their profile or if their pictures look good. So I would love to help you guys out. Feel free to message me. I always leave my Instagram information down below, and follow me while you're at it. A little bit more info about Luxy. The nice thing that I love about Luxy is their verification process, okay? So on Luxy, you can verify your identity, but even more so, even more excitingly, you can verify your income and your net worth, okay? So on Luxy, there is a way where you can submit your pay stubs or your bank statements, something like that, and you can actually become a verified millionaire on their website. So if you are a millionaire, by all means, definitely verify yourself, because I know when I was on the app, I was definitely, you know, looking out for those verified badges, okay? Because there weren't many of them. So as soon as you have a badge, you definitely are more attractive and more appealing to more candidates. I personally did verify my identity, and I did notice a large amount of messages after that. So even if you're not verifying your salary, definitely verify your identity, because all you need to do is send in a picture, I think, of your ID front and back, and that will verify you, which also comes with a badge. So your profile will say verified identity, which lets other users know that you're not fake. So this really, really adds some credibility to your profile. On their website, they feature interracial dating, elite dating, and even senior dating. So they really are catering to everyone here. This is an international dating app, so many times you can find people from different countries, which is awesome. It's worldwide. And I already have reviewed this app in full, to be honest. I've made so many videos about Luxy. I've broken down the different paid accounts you can get. So if you're interested in a full review of Luxy where I break down all the different paid accounts and the features that come with them, I will link it up above. And I also have another video where I talk about the statistics of Luxy users. So if you want to find out how many Luxy users have graduated college, how many of them are making six figures, how many of them are millionaires, then check out that video, which I will link up above right here. And now for our last spot at number 7, drum roll please. You know what? If you can guess what this app is, go leave it in the comments. What do you think the last app at number 7 is? One of my favorites. If you guessed Millionaire Match, then you are correct. Millionaire Match was founded in 2001, and it houses about 4.7 million attractive singles, and it was actually voted best of the web by Forbes.com. Okay, you guys, so if Forbes is saying that, then clearly there is some credibility and trust behind this dating app. The other thing that I love about Millionaire Match, why do you think it's so near and dear to my heart? Well, just like Luxie, they do offer certified millionaire badges on their website, which is just awesome because you can figure out right away if someone is truthful about what they're saying. So on the Millionaire Match website, this is what it says. Once you've achieved a certain level of success, it can be harder than ever to find someone interested in you for who you are and not what you have. That is so true. This can make meeting your special soulmate who is interested in a lasting relationship a difficult challenge. Millionaire Match is an elite club, the largest and high quality millionaire dating site. Do you want to meet someone just as successful as you? Do you want to date a millionaire? Then Millionaire Match was designed with you in mind. For well over a decade, we've been serving a very exclusive elite clientele of rich and attractive men and women, CEOs, pro athletes, doctors, lawyers, investors, entrepreneurs, beauty queens, supermodels, and Hollywood celebrities who are all seeking millionaire dating opportunities and a serious long-term relationship. Why do I love this app so much? They really, really hone in on the serious dating, the marriage. Like, as soon as you visit the Millionaire Match dating website, you can tell that it's kind of like the match.com of elite dating. That's honestly how I would describe it. Like, you can tell that they really, really are hoping to create long-lasting, lifelong partnerships, right? And even on their website, I'm pretty sure they have a section where people share their stories of how they met on there and fell in love and got married. So it's one of those apps where you can really tell that they're doing their best in order to curate real, long-lasting, deep, meaningful connections. So I really, really appreciate that about Millionaire Match. And once again, they have both free and paid memberships. The paid membership is $70 if you just want to try it out for 1 month. It's $45 per month if you commit to 3 months. And it is $35 a month if you commit to 6 months. So that actually wraps up my video. I really hope that this was a helpful guide in your dating journey. Definitely download these apps. If you're single and if you're looking for love, what do you have to lose? Tonight, sign up. There's 7 of these apps and I'm sure one of them will work out for you. I'm sure one of them will bring you that perfect person that you're looking for. So I hope that this was helpful and I will see you all very soon. Bye.